Okay, so while my dog is on my feet, today we have the Mock Turtles and Can You Dig It? So this song was requested, and I guess you would say this band was a one-hit wonder, this being their only hit, I guess. And they were part of the Manchester era, which, you know, I've listened to other bands from that era, and I've loved pretty much everything I've heard. So yeah, we're going to get into this. Try to watch the video here, and I don't know, it might get blocked. We'll see what happens. Anyway, let's get into this one today. The Mock Turtles, like the name, Can You Dig It? Let's go. Okay, so there it is, the Mock Turtles and Can You Dig It? So like I reacted to yesterday, another song where the, you know, such a soft voice here, which I reacted to, the Brian Jonestown Massacre, with of course Anton Newcombe, and his soft vocals. And then today, going to the Mock Turtles, You know, I the voice here of Martin Coogan. And I mean, it's just like, so right off the bat, you know, obviously that sublime guitar, played by Martin, and then the guitar solo in there as well. Just like I said, so sublime and so fitting as well. I just love, you know, that the continuous kind of drive that he had going. And like I also said during the song, the bass line was heavy. I mean, unmissable there. Keyboards were obviously very nice as well. I was going to say frantic for some reason, but keyboards were also, you know, very prominent as well. And yeah, so I mean, everybody here was just, you know, in their pocket. And I just really enjoyed also, you know, watching the video. I really enjoyed Martin's kind of stern face, pretty much everybody's stern face in the video. They all just seemed kind of very serious, which kind of made me laugh at some points, especially how Martin just starts off playing the guitar in the video and, you know, just staring so seriously at the camera. It's just like, my goodness, I feel like I'm being interrogated or something. But anyway, so yeah, I just really like that. And also Martin's dance moves, I was going to say during the song, was, you know, his dance moves were impeccable, but I thought, why not wait until after? And, you know, he looked like he was just feeling the music, you know, especially, you know, making the video and everything. He looked like he was having fun and, you know, dancing around. And I just really enjoyed, I guess the aesthetics of all, you know, his white shirt. I like the guy on drums, the drummer here. I should look at the personnel because, of course, you know, I want to, you know, get people's names right here. But like I said, Martin Coogan, of course, on vocals and guitars. This is for their album, Turtle Soup, which I like the name of the album there. Turtle Soup by the Mock Turtles. I like it a lot. Anyway, Steve Cowan on drums. So Steve there. His shirt, it's an Britain's Naughty Boy, I think it said something like that. So that was kind of nice. Joanne Gent, I want to say, is on keyboards. Maybe it's Ghent, but either way, Joanne, like I said, the keyboards here, I mean, you can hear the rise and the fall of them. That sounds dumb to say, but you can, obviously it was unmissable. You know, the keyboards, the drums, everything here, you know, everybody was so prominent for me anyway, with the headphones in. But obviously, again, Martin's voice, just that soft kind of sublime voice, just to go with a sublime guitar playing, was just great. Andrew Stewartson on bass and Martin Glenn Murray on guitars as well, it says here. And I think, I want to say Martin was, the guy with kind of the blonde hair, I want to say there, dirty kind of blonde hair. And I thought, you know, he would look like a nice looking chap, in my opinion anyway. So, you know, I just wanted to mention that as well. But with this song here, you know, I see, you know, on SongFacts here, just for a little, you know, I guess, context of the band, at least for me as well, because, you know, again, this band is new to me. But, you know, the Mock Turtles were formed in Manchester in 1987. And again, so many great bands have come from Manchester. I mean, my God, and what, again, I always say, but one of my favorites is Oasis. Anyway, the Smiths were from Manchester as well, unless I'm dumb as hell. Anyway, formed by vocalist Martin Coogan, who is the older brother of comedian and actor Steve Coogan. This was the band's only hit single. And again, it goes on, you know, talking about how they were a one-hit wonder. And I mean, for this to be their one hit, I mean, again, it's just like, for the lyrics here, you know, to go to the lyrics here, you know, to talk about the lyrics, I really just have to say, because what it seems like here, you know, this guy, he's talking about how much he's grown. You know, he's talking about, can you dig it? Oh yeah. It seems like he's putting something in the face of somebody. He's like, you know, it seems like he's really telling somebody off here. You know, telling them, you know, you can't control me now. That's what really came to my mind, you know, again, watching the video and not looking at the lyrics until now to get a good understanding. But I mean, how he starts off, you know, with can you understand me now? And again, his delivery, I can't say it enough. His delivery here is just that soft voice. He sounds kind of vulnerable at the same time. Again, for a topic like this, what he's talking about for the subject of the song. But anyway, can you understand me now? I'll get it through somehow. You won't ever get me down. You won't see me hanging around. And of course, the chorus, you know, can you dig it? Oh yeah. And I thought, I didn't know if he was going to kind of raise his voice or something for the chorus. And I mean, he kind of had a little, you know, I was going to say a little bit more passion, but that sounds, you know, kind of rude. He had a little bit more fire, I guess, in the chorus, obviously, than, you know, the verses, I guess you would say. And he kind of, you know, he did kind of raise his voice, I guess. But again, with such a smooth voice or soft voice that he had, you know, he raised it, you know, the only way he can. Anyway, can you dig at what I'm saying? One little kiss isn't anything. I won't be sad while someone turn the lights on. And then again, the second verse here, and the verses I like, they're short. Well, the second verse is short anyway. And then the chorus one more time. That guitar solo and then the chorus and outro. I mean, again, it's such kind of a short and sweet song, but really, you know, it's over 4 minutes, but I mean, it felt pretty short to me. Anyway, see how big and strong I've grown. I'm standing on my own, right into the chorus again. Can you dig it? Oh, yeah. So, like I was saying, it seems like this is maybe a relationship. Again, I don't know if it had to do with, you know, what Martin, from his own personal life, or, you know, if he's talking, you know, from another point of view. But yeah, it seems like he's telling somebody, you know, a significant other or something. And again, that's just my interpretation of, you know, see how big and strong I've grown. I'm standing on my own, you know. Can you dig it that, you know, now you don't control me? Like I said, can you dig it that, you know, I'm moving on or whatever, something like that, you know, I've seen the light, you know, and again, you know, will someone turn the light on? Maybe that's what he's talking about. Anyway, you know, can you dig what I'm saying? One little kiss isn't anything. So again, maybe this, you know, you can't kiss me, you know, well, or whatever. Now, you know, one little kiss doesn't mean anything to me anymore. Also, you know, a song that comes to mind, that has kind of the same themes, you know, thinking of like Self-Esteem by The Offspring. I mean, way different, but you know, another song from the 90s, I'm pretty sure. And, you know, that same kind of thing, but where I guess in Self-Esteem, the guy does give in and, which is way different from, the message here where it seems like he says, can you dig it that I'm fucking, you know, out of here. Anyway, and yeah, like I said, the guitar solo in there, I mean, I really just enjoyed, Martin's guitar playing here. I don't know if he gets enough credit, that he should, because again, you know, talking about a one-hit wonder here and the Mock Turtles, you know, me never really hearing about them. His guitar playing was sublime. I keep coming back to that word sublime, but his guitar playing was just, you know, it just fits so well with the song. And I mean, from the opening kind of spiraling that he's doing, and then, you know, like I said, onto this guitar solo, and again, his straight face while he's doing it, it's just perfect. And, and it fits so well with his voice still. Because, you know, it's not like he's not like showing off very much or whatever with his guitar here, but, and his, you know, with such a soft voice and everything, it just fits so well for me anyway. So, I mean, I can't fawn over this enough. I guess I can see why this was a hit, and, I guess, you know, and it sucks obviously that, I guess they didn't find another hit, but anyway. And of course, you know, like I was saying, you know, chorus one more time, the outro, can you dig it, can you dig it? And again, I just love pretty sure there's backing vocalists on here as well. Well, the band was doing backing vocals as well. And they fit, you know, behind Martin very well as well. You know, everybody, nobody had such a harsh voice or anything, or like a very big baritone, because, you know, Martin's voice is kind of, you know, high on its own. So I really just enjoyed what everybody came to do here. And also, I just wanted to say, I see that this was, you know, searching the song up, I see that it has been used in commercials and stuff. You know, ads and all this stuff. And I see that some people say it's ruined it. The song has been ruined for them because, you know, it just reminds them of a commercial for a phone or something like that. So, I mean, hopefully at least, you know, the band is making some money off of that. You know, Martin and the boys and Joanne here. You know, hopefully they're getting paid for all that. And, yeah, so like I said, I just really enjoy it. And again, Turtle Soup. I just like the name of the album and, you know, the name of, you know, the Mock Turtles. Obviously, I think of the Turtles from the 60s, but I like how they changed it up here with the Mock Turtles, you know, where a mock turtle. I mean, I don't know how they come up with it, but I like it a lot. So anyway, holy moly. Oh, shit. But yeah, as somebody fires up the lawnmower outside and I almost die from coughing, like I said, I really enjoyed this, you know, One Hit Wonder again. It would be interesting, I guess, just to, you know, check out another song from them that I guess, you know, because again, they're a One Hit Wonder, you call them. So just to see what else they have. And what I guess didn't make it to the top of the charts. So anyway, and this did reach number 18 in the UK. So, I mean, pretty good. Better than I'll ever do. So yeah, thanks for watching, I guess I'll say. Thanks for requesting. Again, I like this song, I have to say. My goodness gracious. Another Manchester band. I can dig it, I'll tell you what. And yeah, so thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. Really appreciate all the support. And I will talk to you guys again soon.